Well, come on, somebody. He's the unmovable rock. As long as you're on the rock, you can go through waters, you can go through trials and tribulations. But my identity is not in what I have. My God, my identity is in who is mine. My identity is in Jesus Christ, my God. As long as he's in the throne,
yes.
I don't need to worry. No, that's all. Don't worry. Be happy. Not with marijuana. Be happy with Christ. Come on, somebody.
Hallelujah.
All right, so Jesus now is what? Jesus is what? The image of the invisible. Read to me Hebrews now, chapter 1, verse 3.
Who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person and upholds all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high.
Oof. To understand our image, you need to understand Jesus. He is the expression of what? The glory. This is powerful. Woo! You know, when Peter had a revelation of Christ, because Christ said, who did the man say him? Well, they said you're the prophet. They said you're John the Baptist. They said, well, who do you say him? The Son of the living God. Man has not revealed this to you, only my Father. When we have a revelation of Christ, your life will never be the same. We have a revelation of religion. We have a revelation of man's doctrines and man's dogmas, but we don't have a revelation of Christ. Because the moment we have the revelation of Christ, my God, nothing is going to stop us. I'm here to speak to about three or four men who say nothing is going to stop you in life, not because you're strong, not because you have the resources. God will always call you to do the impossible, because when you walk by faith to do the impossible, he will bless you, to, my God. And he'll give you the resources you need to complete the impossible. The problem is we're looking at what we could do. And God is saying, stop looking at what you could do and stop looking at what I could do. Because I am the glory of my Father. And because I am the glory of my Father, when you walk with me, that glory walks with you. That's why people will look at you and say, you look different. You smell different. Why are you happy when everybody else is sad? How could it be that I have $300,000 in my bank account and you have $44 to your name, but you're still happy and you still see provision? I'm here to declare to someone that your house will not see lack. And if your house does see lack, there will always be provision for the vision. Somebody say provision for the vision. It's time to expand and start to expand. Somebody said stretch. It's time to stretch our faith and stop believing God for the possible and start believing him for the impossible. Right. I'm going to believe God for Pastor Gabe that this building, and this is not the church. This is not the church. We're the church. The Bible says that God does not, he's not in a place where man made. This is the building, but the church is us who gets together. And because I'm the church, the altar of God is inside of me. And when there's an altar, there's fire. What we need nowadays are men who know who they are and walk with the fire of the Holy Spirit. Because when you walk with the fire of the Holy Spirit, you're going to start doing things that you thought that were impossible, and you're going to see it possible. The problem is that every time you walk by faith, there's going to be two or three people who are going to say, it's impossible, Pastor. You can't do it, kid. We don't have the money. We don't have the resources. But I declare that even in this place will be even enlarged. This place will be bigger. And more souls will come for Christ. And more people will come for Christ. And we will see such a revival in this city. How many say amen?
Hallelujah.
Say amen like you believe.
Amen.
Don't say amen like, well, I guess it's going to happen. It's going to happen.
Amen.
Amen. Sorry, Felix.
It's going to happen.
Woo. Thank you, Jesus.
You will see restoration in your family. You will see provision in your house.
Yes.
The Bible says that the Lord is what? My what? My shepherd. And I shall not what?
No.
Thank
but
you.
But until we have a revelation of who's Christ, we don't know what's our rights. If I don't know my rights, I don't know my legal rights in the kingdom of God, then I have no say so because I don't know. My people perish because of what?
Lack of knowledge.
So they walk around complaining all day. If you're a complainer, you're here, stop complaining.
That's good.
I started complaining about me being fat all day. I'm fat. Check it, I'm fat. Do something about it! So I go to the park and I walk. I don't drink soda. Stop complaining about it. I gotta do something about it.
Right.
Stop complaining about being miserable and do something about it.
Amen.
Stop complaining about your problem and stop declaring the word of God.
Yes.
Imagine Jesus Christ was walking around complaining to his disciples. Well, disciples, I don't know what we're going to do now. Well, disciples, this is... Well, I don't know, Peter, you want to walk on water? I don't know, think about it. Imagine, no, man, when Jesus walked, things started to happen.
Yes. Oh, yes.
And if Jesus did it, he said we could do it.
Amen.
Why? Because he's the image. He came back to us to restore our identity in us. I'm hurrying up. There's two or three who I don't want to go. Say, Brother Thomas, you're screaming too much. No, is that when I speak about Christ, something happens inside of me. Woo! This is the living water that the Bible says.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Listen to this now. So you read Hebrews, right? Now listen to this. Colossians chapter 3, verse 7 through 10. I want you to read this for me, so I'm going to use our Bibles. Somebody get it. Colossians chapter 3, 7 through 10. And someone else is going to look up Ephesians chapter 4, 17 through 24. Colossians 3, 7 through 10, and Ephesians 4, 17 through 24. The Bible says here, let me give you a summary. We are transformed or renewed into the image of God by the gospel. This is not something that man can bring about his own efforts, but by receiving Christ in faith and repentance. Can someone read to me? Colossians chapter 3, verse 7 through 10. Someone has it? You got it?
Yeah. In which you yourself once walked when you lived in them. But now you yourselves are to put all these anger, wrath, malice.
Well, I need that. You know what man could do? Put away anger. There are men who get angry so quick, and that's why they destroy their relationships, even in the churches. I had a brother in my church who was angry. Every little thing tipped him off. Some anger issues. Why are you so angry? Because there's things that are in there, and that's not the image of God. What did he say? He said, put away anger. Put away wrath. The Bible says, you could be angry, but don't sin. Anger is an emotion that God has given us to use it in the right way. Amen? But continue.
But now you yourselves are to put all these anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy language.
Woo! Whoa. What is that? Filthy language. Have I ever cursed? Of course I have. Preacher, you said a bad word, of course. Man, there was a man that was driving. I think my father, I found out my father was in the car with me. Somebody passes up and I said a bad word. My father goes, Kenny, you're a preacher? My father, first